The final and third reading of the amendment bill also limits the tenure of a university registrar to a single five-year term.
Informed by the new insights from relevant stakeholders, the committee resolved to amend the titles of the bills referred to. This was to make room for separate acts that will cater for universities on the one hand and the Federal Polytechnics and Colleges of Education on the other.
Senators also amended Section 9 of the Principal Act by substituting it with a new Clause 9, which now provides that an academic staff who retires in a recognized university shall be entitled to pension at a rate equivalent to his or her annual salary.
To become a professor, you're going up on the merit ladder, and you must be recognized. Every academic staff in a university aspires to achieve the status of a professor. That is the pinnacle.
And this recommendation was brought to us by ASU itself.
For academic staff in the professorial cadre and non-academic staff, and other matters connected therewith, 2012, third reading.
But having passed these bills now, the university staff will return and call off, ASU will call off their strike, and they will go back to the universities.
Senate and the Committee of the Whole had also confirmed President Jonathan's nomination of NTA's Mrs. Eugenia Abu and Mr. Olawale Fapounda, a legal practitioner, as members of the National Human Rights Commission. Meanwhile, the Chairman Senate Committee on Petroleum Downstream, Senator Magnus Abe, has welcomed the efforts of the executive towards fast-tracking the passage of the Petroleum Industry Bill.
If we all put the interest of Nigeria first, finding a common ground and passing a law would actually enable the petroleum industry to develop for the benefit of the Nigerian people will not be too difficult an assignment.
Senator Abe, who is the chairman of the Senate Joint Committee investigating the administration of fuel subsidy, said they are substantially in possession of a lot of answers on the issues.
Are we satisfied with all the answers we got? Definitely not. But did we get answers? I think Nigeria, not just the committee, Nigeria got quite a lot of answers from that process.
The Senate Joint Committee investigating the administration of fuel subsidy in Nigeria is to hold a public hearing next week. Among stakeholders invited include importers and marketers of refined petroleum products. Senate reconvenes plenary on Thursday. From the National Assembly, Muhammad Kudu Abubakar, NTA News.